Hello everybody, this is Grimmy, and thank you so much for 70,000 subscribers. As promised, this is the Q&A, and I have a lot of questions to go through. But before I do that, I felt I should give a basic introduction about myself, since a lot of people are new here. So yes, I'm Grimmy, I'm a 23-year-old woman living in England. I'm a freelance artist and part-time lecturer. Also, this is Jaggers, he's my mascot for the channel. He's a dude, and not me. I often see people get confused that they're like, wait, you're a girl, but your character. And I'm like, yeah, I know. Just go along with it, it's fine. With that said, so yeah, very basic introduction. I'll get started on the questions. I am going to like say people's names and then you read out the question. So if I mispronounce any of your names, usernames, I'm really sorry. Also, there were quite a few overlapping questions. So what I did is that if you were asking multiple questions and one of the many questions you were asking overlapped with one of the singular questions, like for example, a few people asked me about pets, but only one person asked me one question that were about my pets. So if you see that you've posted a question, a post with multiple questions and some of them are like not there, it's because I cut them out because I already answered them. Mr. W asks, how are you? I'm all right. All things considered, I'm very well. I'm doing well. Just Skits asks, how did you find the Dream SMP? I watched a video talking about Cryotic. Because he was going through, he admitted to doing some bad things, and I was like, oh, well, that's a shame. I remember him back in the day with PewDiePie, okay. And then I saw a video of Dream's Manhunt. I was like, I got confused because the Cryotics and Dream's like blob mascot dude, I got confused. I was like, that looks weirdly similar to Cryotic, what the heck? Normally I would have just, you know, not paid attention to it, but I saw how many views it had and I was like, what is this? And so I clicked on it and it was a, you know, one of Dream's Manhunts. I think Ant had just been introduced into it. I think so, Ant Frost had just joined, I think. And I was like, oh, this is actually kind of fun. I'd never touched Minecraft before that point. I've never played Minecraft until like this year, or last year rather. And I saw that, I was like, oh, that's kind of funny. And I watched more of his videos. And then a Dream SMP video was suggested to me. I was like, I don't know what that is. I think the first video I saw of a Dream SMP was, so I think it was a Manberg arc video. And Schlatt was telling Tubbo to destroy some signs, like some messages or something, and like Eric and somebody else were telling him like don't do it basically, and I was like, what is going on, what's happening? And Tubbo destroyed the signs, and then Tubbo started crying, or like pretend crying, I don't know, getting emotional, and I was like, why is somebody bullying this child, what is happening? And then I looked in the comments and I was like, oh, it's role play, they're role playing. And I got really curious because I was like, oh, like the content, like the streamers seem really invested in their story, like and then it started. When did you enter the Dream SMP fandom? So I made my first animatic on the January 3rd 2021. I guess that's when I entered it really, because that's when I started making content for it, but I was lurking around the fandom like about a month earlier or so, like during the end of November type of thing. And I was like, ooh, it's dramatic. I'm into that, I like dramatic. So I guess, yeah, I guess it's like end of 20, would it been 2020? Yeah, end of 2020, end of 2020. What is the main reason that you wanted to join the fandom of the Dream SMP? And also for a side question, what fandom were you in before the Dream SMP? The main reason was just I was really invested in the story. I liked people's acting. Specifically, what got me into, like what really caught my attention was Tommy. I really liked his acting, and I was like, so again, also so I thought Tommy and Tubby were like 12. I didn't realize they were like 16 and 17. I was like, ah, my bad, sorry. And I was like, well, this kid is like really good at acting. So that's like the main reason that I joined it. I didn't really want to join it. I just happened to join it because Tommy was like, look at my traumatic character. And I was like, I like that traumatic character. And which fandom I was in before? Honestly, I've never really been in fandoms the same way I've been with, in a fandom, the same way I've been with, in the Dream SMP. But I guess I was in the boys animata, a fandom before, rather. Not the TV show, well, a kind of the TV show, but like just generally the comic books of the boys comic books, which if you are a minor, do not read them, do not watch it. It is very much for adults only. Which I know is going to make you, some of you want to look it up, but like, be warned, not for children. Jelly Tea asks, who inspired you to do Dream SMP animations? Also, who is your favorite Dream SMP character? Okay, so the favorite Dream SMP character, if you look 5 seconds on my channel, I think you'll be able to tell who it is. Technically, definitely. No, it's Sam, it's Sam, it's definitely Sam. Awesome dude, definitely awesome dude. And who inspired me to make... Now, for a lot of people, the answer would be, I think, Saddest, most likely. I didn't know who she was at all. I think the main person who really got me into making animatics is Amber Rose Moon. Specifically, it was, Dream's Threat to the Manberg. I think Amber Rose really influenced the way I do eye shapes, is specifically Tommy. Ambrose is the main one who inspired me to do Dream SMP animatics, for sure. When I first found the Dream SMP, was I instantly drawn to Sam's streams, or did you bounce around to other creators before finding Sam? Alright, so complete transparency, I didn't know Sam existed. Because I joined like just as the disc's like arc ended, basically. And as the prism started, and I wasn't aware Sam existed. I wasn't aware many characters existed. I got Punk and Puns confused. You know, that's how little I knew about the other characters. If they weren't Tommy, Tubbo, and Dream, and technically I didn't know who they were. At the time, I was only drawn to Tommy's character, mostly. And obviously Dream's, but Dream doesn't stream Dream SMP, so... But I think after I got... So I think it was after Tommy's death, like Sam just saw like reaction to the whole thing, and then Ali Oof's song, Just a Kid. That is what really interested me into the character, because I am weak for like characters like Sam's. I am so weak for them. So that's how it happened. I was watching Tommy's streams and then Sam popped up to them and I was like, hold on a second, hold it. This guy interests me. Also, his accent's nice. I like it. Who is he? And that's how I got drawn to his character. When was it that you realized that Sam was your favorite Dream SMP character? When he chopped off Pong's arm. Which, first impressions are important. He made a first impression. Because I knew him from the prison, and I was like, oh, he's really interesting. Like, he's really strict with the rules, and like, he seems to have like a soft spot for Tommy. I was like, that's really interesting. I don't know much about that. So I looked it up and I was like, oh, that's really interesting. And then I don't know how, but I stumbled onto Punk's lore somehow. And him, and there was the one where when he stole the keycards and got his arm chopped off. And I was like, hello? Minecraft roleplay? What is this? And that's when I realized it was my favorite. It was just like the duality of this man. The many faces he has. I love it. Summon of Dreams from Instagram asks, what drew you to Osamdude's character specifically? What makes him such a central character for you? Even in your art, Sam is often the more detailed and more care is given to his motions than expressions. Yeah, so that's my bias showing, first of all. You'll see this a lot. If a character is clearly my favorite, they will have like the most detail in them, which is something I do need to stop doing because it's unfair to the other characters, but like, I can't help myself. I love him too much. What drew him specifically? Like I said, I'm really weak to sort of dad characters, which like Sam's not a dad character necessarily, but he is like a like authority fatherly figure, but it tends to have like a really strict side, but is like so kind-hearted. And I know a lot of people who don't know Sam's character be like, look what you did to Rambu. And I'm like, before Rambu, before the whole corruption thing, okay, before all of that, look at, okay. I just really liked how, like, I don't know, how genuinely, like, well-meaning he was, and like how he genuinely just tried his best to do what he thought was right. And at the time, at the beginning, it was really genuine, and like he wasn't doing anything wrong. Like he got, you know, he got trapped by the egg, and he was trying to, you know, he was just giving people visits to see Dream and all that stuff. And he was like, you know, it wasn't until Tommy died that he really broke down as a character. And so I really liked his character. So obviously my first real impressions of him was after Tommy died. But then I watched his earlier lore and I was like, oh, he has a completely, like, there's like a clear progression in his character. And I think what's interesting is that his character is, instead of like having character development, it's still development, but it's like, instead of becoming a better person, his character's breaking down. And I think we don't see that often in mainstream done so well, like Sam does. And that really drew me to him. And I just don't know, I really like the way Sam as well voices his character and how he writes his character. And I think just like the content creator Sam himself is just so good at adding like depth to his own character that I think a lot of people don't appreciate. And honestly, I should just make like a character analysis of, or like an opinion piece on Sam. But like, oh, it's just too much. I don't have the time. But there's just so much about Sam that I absolutely adore. And I think just Sam writes his character so well. And I think that in itself, like, is what drew me to Sam specifically. I think if Sam was written by anybody else other than Sam, I would not like Sam the way I do. I said Sam too many times in that sentence. Master Creeper asks, why are you an Awesome Dude fan? Why are you not an Awesome Dude fan? Is the real question. Look at him. Look at both of them. Why wouldn't I be a fan? Also because he's a sweetheart. Somewhat Nerd asks, if you were to like any other characters in the Dream SMP the most besides Sam, who would it be? It would be Dream and Tommy. Dream and Tommy are my two follow-up favorite characters. Filza in the Limbo asks, besides Sam, who's your favorite character to animate? Okay, so my favorite character to draw would probably be Sapnap after Sam, which is ironic because I haven't drawn him much, but I really like playing around with Sapnap's like fire and emotions and stuff. So I really like doing that. Who else do I like to draw a lot? I like to draw all of them. Tommy's always fun to draw. I guess Dream's face specifically is fun to draw because I like making him look like really creepy and like completely unhinged. So I guess that as well. Alana Artroyd asks, I know Sam and Jim are your favorite characters in Dream SMP. What other character do you really like? So obviously Tommy, but I also really like Foolish, I really like Punk, Quackity. Catherine asks, what other Dream SMP members do you like other than Sam and Dream? Like content creator Dream? I don't watch his videos anymore unless they're like Manhunt. I'm really basic. I don't like him, I don't watch his content enough. Well, other than members I like are that I watch regularly, I'd say rather, because I like all of them. I don't have anything against any of them. Would be I watch Schlatt's videos regularly. I watch Tommy's videos. I watch a vlog and all. I like Jack Manifold's videos a lot. I think they're really funny. His boxing one's my favorite, and I watch his VODs as well. H-Bomb, I like his videos a lot. Those are the main ones, mainly that I watch more, and I quote unquote like how to put it. I don't dislike any of the others. They're just like the content creators I watch the most of. What do I usually practice for drawings and stuff? Okay, this is gonna sound weird. I don't practice anymore these days. I just draw. I just go down and draw. If I'm struggling with something, like it's more like if I'm trying to draw something for a piece and I can't do it, then I'll draw it. And that will usually be like feet, usually, if I have to draw feet or shoes or stuff like that. Because I find them difficult to draw. Hands, I'm okay with, to be fair. Not perfect, but like I can make it work in my style. Favorite moments on the Dream SMP? Obviously any Sam moments, obviously I will enjoy by default. The scene where Hannah is hiding from the egg, Sam told her to hide in the basement. The egg was talking to her and telling her to come back, basically. And the egg pie people left and Sam was like, yeah, bye guys, bye. And then Hannah's like behind him, basically, and he's like, "What are you doing here? What are you doing?" And they're just like having like a whisper like argument. It's really funny. I like that one a lot. So I don't want to say that's my favorite, but honestly, yeah, just a lot of Sam moments are my favorite. Thoughts on Dream XD? What about other upshot characters in SMP? No thoughts on Dream XD. Characters like Dream XD don't particularly interest me. Again, not that he's bad, and he's got some very funny moments. Like him and Foolish are really funny. But I don't really have any opinions on Dream XD. It's like one of his characters. Like, oh, cool. He's canon. He exists. Cool. I'll stay aware of what he's doing so I know what's happening in the lore, but like, I'm not that invested, if that makes sense. What about other obscure characters in the SMB? What would consider an obscure character? I guess if you're talking like Mamacita and Mexican Dream, it's like, oh cool, they exist. I will keep in mind that they exist. I don't really have any opinions about other obscure characters in the SMB. I don't even think DreamXD is an obscure character these days, to be fair. I don't know. Alexa Riona Aguinaldo asks, what was the most stupid thing you thought when you first joined the fandom? I don't know what you mean by that, but I think, the most stupid thing I thought when I first joined must have been like not understanding that it was a roleplay at first. So I was like, why is Tubbo being bullied? Who is this child? Who is this schlatt man being rude? What is happening? So I think that was probably the most stupid thing I thought. If you mean like what was the most stupid in the fandom, it's people like getting like pointless like infighting within the fandom over things that don't matter, like, and like, just people being dumb, basically just internet, just Twitter things, you know, like people will like try to cancel Quackity for speaking Spanish or something, and I was like, what? What? He's Mexican, you know, I've just joined and I know this. What? And also, what's wrong with speaking Spanish? What? So I think the endless fighting over petty things like that, like really stupid things like that, was just like, that's what I thought was the stupidest thing, because it's like, it's just, you're wasting your time. Oof asks, how do you like to represent each person's chat on their Dream SMP? I like to represent them as they are in canon, so like some things like, obviously like Filza has crows, Technoblade has the voices, Tommy is that funny little TV set guy. Sam's are enchantment table, the enchantment table signs thingies. I've used them in a few of my comics and stuff. Punks are lemons, you know, so I try to use whatever's canon. If, like, for example, Eret has ferrets. If some of them don't have a canon chat, like Sapmap, for example, I make them something like relevant to the character. So for example, with Sapnap, I do like little floating fireballs, stuff like that. For like other characters, so I haven't really thought about other characters, like let's say like Puns or Purpled or something like that. I haven't thought about them because I haven't had the need to, but I'd probably do something that's like relevant to their character or something that I can use. Equinox Dragon asks, Grimmy Jaggers, what do you imagine your chat comment section as? What form do you imagine we take if we do take a form? If you're part of my live streams, you would know this. You guys are all little fat chunky robins, because robins are my favorite birds, and I think having just fluff balls of robins all around me peeping very loudly is adorable, and I think having little birds demanding bread and to commit arson is hilarious. So you guys are little chunky robins. Except for Melon, who for some reason is a crab because he's in charge of the crab raves whenever I'm off stream. So, Captain Jet Free Fly Fire asks, thought on Dream XD. Do you like him as much as Dream and Sam? Finally, what do you think of Foolish's spills? I already answered this. I don't think anything of Dream XD. He's like, he exists, and he's an interesting dynamic of some of the characters. I don't think I will ever have anybody I like as much as Dream and Sam, to be honest, except for Tommy. Finally, what do I think of Foolish's builds? I really like them. I am not a builder by any means. Like, I can barely build like a wall in Minecraft. I think Foolish's builds are really impressive. Yeah, and no, I can't imagine the amount of time it takes him to do things. He was losing his mind with the mana, like like man's dedicated, and I can respect that, and they also look really, really cool, and he's very cool. Oh, Mistred's W again asks, who from the Dream SMP do you hate, don't like? I don't hate or dislike any of the Dream SMP members, if that's what you're asking. Character-wise, it's not even because of the character's fault or the content creator's fault that I don't like this character. It's 100% the fandom, which, yeah, it sounds awful, but I don't like Technoblade's character, like, at all. He used to be my favorite when I first joined the SMP, but after watching more of his lore, after the fandom's reaction to my take on his character, I was like, yeah, you know what? No, I don't enjoy this character. He's not fun. whenever he's on screen, I get exasperated, I get tired. I was not looking forward to his stream when Sam was put in prison, because I was like, no. I don't know. I don't really enjoy Technoblade's character anymore, which is a shame, because I used to really like him. I'd say he's the only character I don't like, and it's not even the content creator's fault, or even the character itself's fault, it's mainly the fandom's, and the fandom's reaction to everything. And I think it's because, like, because Technoblade is, like, such, like, a beloved content creator, and so many people watch his his point of view, people only watch his point of view, and don't see, like, other characters' points of view. And I think for me, who is mainly an Osam Dude artist, that becomes really tiring, because then I get people coming in giving the same talking points as Technoblade's character, not even Technoblade himself, Technoblade's character. And it's like, yeah, but Technoblade's character isn't the end all of lore knowledge. He knows literally nothing about the rest of the lore. So it's like, I get tired because of that side of the Dream SMP. So if anything, I don't even hate Technoblade or hate, like, the character. I don't even dislike the character. I just don't like Technoblade's fan base for the most part. The ones that have been rude to me, at least, I don't appreciate it because they make me tired. Or the ones that are really disrespectful in my comment section, I don't like it. Alyssa asks, out of all the Dream SMP characters in Dream SMP, who did you the most? I just answered that, Techno. Question two, is your character mascot inspired by Osam Dude? No, he's not. I made him years and years ago. If I can find the old image, I'll put it up on screen. But no, I made him ages ago. It's complete coincidence that both our characters are green. Complete coincidence. Question three, what do you like about Technoblade Tommy? I don't know what you mean. I like Tommy just because I think Tommy's acting is really good. I like the character because I think the character, I just find the character's journey interesting and sad, and he's fun to draw. And because Tommy's good at acting, drawing Tommy is really fun. I like the content creator Technoblade because I think he sounds chill and fun, and he vibes well with the others. What do I like about Technoblade character? I like him the most when he's bloodthirsty and fighting, and I like that aspect of him. Victor Hugo asks, am I sad that Sam has been killed in Dream SMP? No, I'm ecstatic. It's up. I can't wait to draw it. I have no idea. I can't wait. I've got it all, like, already planned out and everything, but I can't draw it yet because responsibilities and priorities. But it's on the list. Couple weeks. Give me a month or so. I'll get it done. Jelly Phantom asks, I have been answered before, but here's my question. What tips can you give for us when you draw, and what free app do you use? I don't use any free apps. All the drawing apps I use, I pay for. My friend uses Far Alpaca, and that seems to work really well for her, so Far Alpaca is free, I'm pretty sure. What tips can I give to you when you draw? Have fun. There's nothing worse than forcing yourself to finish something or getting anxious over little details and nuances and stuff like that. Just have fun, just relax, you know. If you stress while you draw, your drawing's gonna come out looking worse for it than if you were just, you know, having fun. It doesn't matter if the drawing is perfect or not, as long as you're having fun. You will naturally get better over time by just drawing and practicing and having fun. So what tip can I give you? Don't stress about drawing, just enjoy it. Arctic Wolf asks, I would like to know what drawing apps you use. So I use mainly Clip Studio, Paint Pro, or on my laptop, with my tablet, but on my iPad, I use Procreate. Also, if you want, like, the specifics of what I have, like all my materials and everything, they're always available in all the descriptions of my videos, and they'll be available in this one as well. It's Emma asks, what is my favorite animatic that you've done? Probably the Sam Attacks Dream animatic, because I just like the whole vibe of it, and I like the idea of Sam going feral at that moment, and just, it was just really fun to draw, and not to be biased or anything, but I really like my Sam head cannons with his design and everything. So yeah, so definitely that one. Charlie asks, what is my favorite thing person to draw? Sam! At the moment, drawing Sam, both the content creator and the character, are my favorite thing to draw. But outside of Dream SMP, probably my OCs. I like drawing my OCs. I like having the freedom to do whatever I want with my OCs, so probably that. Chloe Mbako asks, what was my first animation ever? Did it turn out well? It was, no. My first animation ever is Grimmy is Happy to See You, back when Jaggers was called Grimmy Jaggers. And it's basically just a gloomy looking Grimmy noticing you and, you know, smiling at you, basically. It was not good. Like, it's not bad, but it's like, it's very static and it's clearly not fluid. So, no, is the answer. I don't dislike it. It's just, you look at it and you're like, that was made by someone who had no idea what they were doing, because I had no idea what I was doing. What is the most difficult part when you're doing an animation, like editing, drawing, or finding the good audio? Honestly, it's just how time-consuming it is. Editing, audio editing is like actually the easiest for me to do because I have fun doing it. I'd say it's probably, I think that's probably the sketching part because the way I do my sketches is that I listen to the audio and I stop, I sketch, I stop, I sketch, I stop, I sketch. And when it's a really long animatic, like for example with the jailbreak one, that gets so tedious after a while. So it's probably the sketching part. Because once I've done the drawing, I can just put any audio I want and just like listen to it while I'm drawing. But when I'm doing my sketches, it's like I've got to stop and start, and that's just so time consuming. Probulous Cat asks, how did you develop your art style? Did you take any art classes? Okay, so I always get asked that about how did you develop your art style? I didn't develop anything. I just drew and my art style appeared. You don't develop knowingly your art style. You can attempt to force an art style if you want, but I'd say typically speaking, your art style just develops on its own, depending on, you know, what mediums, what sort of art styles you tend to consume in your everyday life anyway. Did I take any art classes? Yes, I have a Bachelor of Arts, specifically cartoons and comic arts. I took live drawing lessons for a whole month in Italy. I did do arts like classes in school, but I don't that didn't really help. I was doing like more like traditional art, like painting and stuff like that, not like cartoons like I am. If anything, my teacher was like, no cartoons. I was like, oh. So, but they did teach me some other skills other than art. But I'd say, so yeah, I did take art classes. Boy, how long have you been animating for? Who inspired you in terms of art style? So I've been, okay, so I don't really animate as a thing. People often, they call my animatics animating. It's not animation like at all. It's glorified storyboards at best. But I've been doing animatics for a couple years now. First animatic was about 4 years ago. It was Evelyn Evelyn, an Osamatsu animatic. I can't animate to save my life. I hate animating, actually. I really do. I can't stand like the frame by frame stuff. I find it so boring. Who inspired you in terms of art style? Honestly, probably anime. Honestly, probably Tite Kubo. Who, if you, he is the creator of Bleach. Bleach is my all-time favorite anime. Like, I adore Bleach. It's so good. Which I think is really funny because Filz's Minecraft skin is based off Urahara Kisuke, and my name is based off Grimmjow. Jagger Jags, and it's like, yes, Bleach! Oh, I want to see it! So probably Tite Kubo, but also European Belgian comic books like Tintin, Asterix and Obelix, Lucky Luke, all those book comic books I grew up with, and I think that inspired my style. Also Disney, because I loved like Beauty and the Beast as growing up and everything. So definitely like the things I watched as a kid definitely inspired my style, but I think my style became more distinct after I started getting to anime and Bleach, and that's when I was like, I want to draw really bad, really badly. I want to do that. Oh, also draw badly because of my art at the time. Oof. Oof. Galaxy Queen Cami asks, how long does a normal short animatic take to finish? 2 3 days over the span of a week, basically. How do I go about character designs? I just pick whatever I think is cool, and then I add details as I go along. A lot of the times with my character designs, it will be, I thought this was kind of quirky and kind of fun. And I was like, I'm gonna add it, and it's gonna look great. And then I add details based on that. Or it's like, I want to, or it's like in my head, I'm like, I want a character with like, I don't know, purple hair. Then I make a character with purple hair and I just start from there, basically. It's usually starts off with, I want this, or I think this is cool, and then I start. I don't, that's usually how it is. Whenever you first start to become serious of art, about when I started secondary school, so about 13, 14. Yeah, that's when I was like, yeah, I want to do art like more than just something I doodle once in a while. Like, I actually want to like draw a lot. I didn't know I want to become, I didn't think of it as a career. I thought of it as a glorified hobby, like a thing to do on the side. Do I like any other fandoms other than Dream SMP? No. I don't even like the Dream SMP fandom that much, honestly. I like the people who I talk to. I like the people who are in my community and everything. But it's like, I don't like fandoms in general. Fandom culture, I'm just not a huge fan of in general. Haha, fan. I've had strange experiences with fandoms in the past, and so my attitude generally is to just keep to my side of the internet. I just keep stay in my corner. I don't interact with anyone, and I only interact with people if they interact with me or if I really like them. So yeah, and it's just because I don't really, yeah. I've had some weird experiences to just keep to myself more than anything, and I just generally don't really like fandoms, generally speaking. Yeah, no, I don't like fandoms, that's all I can say, I'm sorry. Brian Messer asks, how do I blend the characters with the background? So from what I understand, it means like, how do I make the characters fit with the background? Usually what you want to do is you want to, how to put it? You want to make sure the character lives in the background, if that makes sense. So for example, have the character interacting with the background, have the lighting be the same as the background. Consider the background like you would the character. Don't consider them two different things, is basically what I would say. You know, for us, the character and the background demand different skill sets, but to the character, to that world, it's the same world, it's the same skill set. As a good starting point for practicing, I say, like, use the same pen thickness, use the same type of colors, the same lighting, have the character, you know, use shadows to show where the character is in that background, interacting with the world, you know, just little things like that, little details like that, which you think, you know, might not change much or you think might be obvious. In the long term, you'll notice how it affects how everything looks. Hani Camelia Fidaus asks, how many frames do you use for your animatic and how many frames did you use for the Jailbreak animatic? Usually my animatics are over 100 frames long, generally speaking. My Jailbreak animatic was, I think, just over 700 frames. Yeah, just over 700 frames, yeah. Nightmare Grim asks, out of all your animations from 2020 to 2022, which one is your favorite? Okay, so I know I said the Sam Attack's Dream animatic. It's still my favorite Dream SMP animatic. I think my favorite animatic, though, that I've made during that time span would probably be the one I did just before I started doing Dream SMP animatics, which is All I Want for Christmas. It includes my friend's characters from her comic called Rothschild, but she hasn't posted yet, but she's working on it. And I just had a lot of fun making it, and it's just really funny. So it's probably that one. That's my favorite out of like 2020 to 2022. I still love drawing Sam though, it's definitely up there with my favorites. Mustard Pumpkin asks, if you didn't do Dream SMP animatics, what would your animatics be about? The same, it would have been the same as before I did Dream SMP animatics. It'd be mostly about my original characters. It'd be about, you know, one-off animatics about things I enjoy, like the boys, maybe Italia. But just, you know, other things I enjoy, just one-off ideas, basically. The girl with the cat hoodie asks, what inspired your design? And I checked in with them, they meant my designs in general. Again, it's just what I think looks cool. Or if I mean like my Dream SMP designs, I based them very heavily on the original Minecraft skin and just sort of like general tropes within the fandom of how people draw them. Because obviously I have my ideas of what I'd like the characters to look like, which are my designs at the moment, but I also wanted to make sure that people in the fandom will be able to recognize the characters to, like, you know who it is and not get confused, basically. My character designs are based off the original Minecraft skin and the general consensus within the fandom. But with some characters like Sam and Foolish, I just said, F you, I'm doing what I want. Yeah, so that's basically that, plus things I like. So for example, why does Technoblade have like, you know, those like sideburns thingy? And I was like, cause of the mutton chops. I was like, cause I'm like, it looks cute. I like it, and it makes me happy to draw them. Princess Emmy asks, what was your favorite part of making the Jailbreak animatic? Honestly, it's being able to draw all the different perspectives and connecting them. I really enjoyed doing that. Again, I think most people only watch Technoblade's point of view, or Tommy's maybe. So it's like, I wanted to add as many points of views, as many aspects of what happened in the Jailbreak as possible. And just seeing that come together just made me really happy, because like, it was really challenging and I really enjoyed that. So yeah, that part was definitely the most fun for me. GZL Dragon asks, where do I animate? I animate in my living room. Kawaii Cupcake asks, what is the moment you really want to animate next? Sam getting murdered. Okay, just like the whole Sam in prison bit. I was like, I'm gonna need to do so much editing with that. Oh, it's gonna be another long one, but I so want to draw it because it's so good. It's so good. If I could do all of the streams in full, if I could draw all the streams in full, all whatever, six whatever of them, all 25 minutes, all 35 minutes, I would, but I cannot. I am but a mere mortal single human. I cannot do all of it, so I'm gonna have to edit it down, but I don't want to. It's too good. Whitey Dude asks, what inspired you to make the This Is Halloween animatic? I don't know. I was like, yeah, this seems like a cool idea. Ba-doom. I think it's because usually during October I do some sort of challenge. Like, usually I do Gortober, but I was like, my my channel is not what it was like a few years ago, so I can't just be drawing gore left and right. I need to, you know, I need to be family friendly, even though chopping people's arms off is family friendly, apparently. So I was like, what can I do? And then I was listening to the This Is Halloween animatic, and I was like, that'd be kind of fun to have, like, you know, all the characters as monsters and just have them, like, introducing that town. And at the first, it was just going to be, like, a one-off concept. And then I was like, I could make, like, a series out of this. I have more ideas for this story. So next Halloween, you guys are getting, like, a few animatics. It's going to be, like, a proper little story. And I'll make, I'm going to have, on AO3, I'm add little, like, fanfics, like, explain sort of the backstories and stuff like that. So, you know. You'll be getting all of that funky stuff. Blueberry from Twitter asks, how do you feel about the This Is Halloween animatic? I like it. I think it's fun. I just had fun making the character designs, honestly. I just had fun. I think some people take it too seriously. Like, they're like, oh, but this logic and that logic. I'm like, there is no logic. I just thought it was cool. I just thought it was fun. And, you know, just take it as it is. It is a fun little goofy thing. It's nothing serious. So I feel very happy about it. I think some people feel too seriously about it. Megan Hasty asks, how satisfying is it when you complete an animatic? It really depends on the video. Some videos I'm like, oh, just get it out. Get it out of my face. But others I'm like, I can't wait for people to cry over this one. So I don't know, it depends. But usually speaking, I'm really happy that it's finished, and I look forward to what people are gonna say about it. I look forward to spreading the Awesome Dude propaganda. Aaron Saar asks, how do you feel about people using getting inspiration from your Dream SMP designs? I don't want people using my Dream SMP designs, if you can avoid it. Taking inspiration from it, I don't care. That's fine. I've taken inspirations from others, that's absolutely fine. But if you're gonna flat out use all of my design, I'd say credit me at the very least. Or I was just like, oh, by the way, this is such and such design. Because I think the thing with Dream SMP is that everybody can just like interpret the characters so differently that it's just easier to make your own version of them than using mine. I've seen people wanting to make fan fictions of my like Dream SMP AUs and stuff like that. I don't like that. Please don't do that. I've said it before in the comment section and stuff like that. I don't like people making fan fictions of my ideas, because it's like, I'm still developing those ideas, they're not finished. So please don't. But like, if you absolutely have to, I'm not, like, listen, I don't want you guys to do fan fiction of my stuff, but like, I also don't want to hinder your creativity. So if you want to use it, you know, I'd appreciate if you didn't, but if you want to, you can just, you know, credit my ideas, because I am very protective of my ideas and I have to get used to not being so protective. But yes, you know, at the end of the day, I'd say just come up with your own ideas. Been inspired by, that's obviously fine. Ashfire asks, what inspired you to, made you want to start animatics YouTube? I can't remember. I just thought it looked fun. I was watching like various like speed paints at the time, and I just thought they were fun to make. So I started doing speed paints, and I don't know. Yeah, I just saw like, I was watching a lot of animatics at the time myself, and I was like, that just seems like something fun to do. I want to try it out. And then I did, like, about 4 years ago. I can't remember anybody specifically that made me want to start, though. Unnamed Genderfluid asks, when you first started drawing and or YouTube, who was and still might be your biggest inspiration? So my biggest inspirations were Lavender Town and Twisted Disaster are the two ones that come up to mind for art specifically. I was watching other YouTubers at the time, obviously, but they didn't like make me want to make my own videos. I'd say those two definitely sort of like what kept me going. Definitely Lavender Town. I remember when I was in secondary school, Lavender Town's videos really like helped me be motivated and have fun with art, because I was just like so downtrodden at the time with my creativity. I was so tired all the time, like emotionally and mentally. And I remember specifically during my breaks, whenever she'd post videos, I would just like be drawing during my breaks while listening to her and like eating my snacks during breaks. And that's like a really comforting memory of mine. I really like that. I like a lot of Lavender's videos, especially like the creepypasta ones. I like those a lot, which is weird because I'm an absolute wimp. I don't like scary things, but I just like the way she tells stories. So definitely Lavender Town. Ready for Life 7040 asks, what did you want to be when you were younger? I know most people who become YouTubers had something else planned, but are you one of them, or did you always want to be a YouTuber? I was doing YouTube for fun. Like, for me, YouTube was and always is, and always that still is, it's, if it works out, that's cool, but it's not my goal. Basically, my intention at the time when I first started YouTube was just to do something fun, have a hobby, because I was really stressed out with school. So it was like just something different, like a different project on the sideline to do. I never had a plan. Even at university, I never had a plan. Like, I remember my last year, which was this year, like I graduated last summer. And my teacher was like, so, you know, what are you doing next? I was like, sir, I don't have a plan A, a plan B, plan C. I have maybe plan D and E, but even those ones are just like, in case everything fails, basically. So I've never had a plan, quote unquote. I've just sort of like, wherever life takes me, I go and I'll keep working hard and see where I end up, basically. Yeah, that's just how I am. That's just how my family is. My family is huge on traveling and I've moved around a lot. So things have just changed so much in my life that making big like life plans and anything just wasn't a concept. It just wasn't a thing. And so things just fell into place for me because I kept working hard. So I never intended on becoming anything. I just was like, if this works out, awesome. If not, we'll try something else. Initially, I was thinking of doing philosophy and English literature at university, but I didn't really want to. Like, I enjoy those topics a lot, but I sort of wanted to do that to go to university to have something to do. And I didn't like that, so I went on a gap year. And then during that gap year, one of my friends I met during that time was like, well, you really enjoy art. Why don't you do something art related? Like comics specifically. And she was from Pennsylvania? Yeah. And she said, or maybe she wasn't from there, but she was like, in Pennsylvania, there's a university that has like comics. And I was like, oh, that's cool. I asked my dad and he was like, absolutely not. America's expensive. And I was like, oh, okay. And he was like, there's one university in England who does something to do with comics. I was like, well, I guess I'm going there. And I went there and I did really well and I'm really happy. And now I do YouTube. But I don't do just YouTube. I do commissions. I do all this thing. I'm just generally a freelance artist. And I do part-time lecturing and everything, so I would say I'm a part-time YouTuber, I'm not a full-time content creator YouTuber. Peter asks, has your view of YouTube changed from when you first started to now? No. I've never been fully invested in YouTube, like, changing. Like, if something changes in YouTube, I'm just like, okay, I guess I'll adapt to it. Like, I've never felt very strongly about it. Also because YouTube is a huge part of my income, but I don't depend solely on YouTube. Like, if things fail with YouTube, I can easily move on, find a job elsewhere, you know? So for me, YouTube isn't as crucial as with other people, where it's literally their entire, like, job. My view hasn't really changed other than, like, it hasn't changed. Shadow Bright Shine asks, so what do you do when people hate on you? Weird question, but I can't think of someone doing that, so how do you handle it? I get two types of hate comments. I get the ones who are clearly written by children who want attention, like, you know, KYS or like, oh, this is shite or something like that, where I'm just like, I don't appreciate it, but I'm just gonna delete your comment because that's rude. And the other one I get is people who hate on me because they hate the character I draw, or like they hate the way I've drawn a character. And with those people, again, I just delete the comment. I know people get really like bitter about people deleting comments. I don't care. If you're gonna be rude to me, you shouldn't expect me to give you attention. If somebody was rude to me in real life, I'd just be like, oh, not my problem. You have a problem with me? Good, thank you for telling me. Sayonara, you don't have to talk to me ever again. Same thing with comments. If you don't like me, thank you for telling me you don't like me. I will delete your comment. You don't have to interact with me ever again. Goodbye, good day. You know, it's just mind your own business and I'll mind mine, you know. I've gotten a couple of like DSMP cringe comments. And I'm just like, there's probably something in your life I don't like about you. So like, sayonara. Like, it's not, I don't like getting these type of comments. It's not that I'm unbothered by them. Obviously, it's like, you know, it's like, my feelings. Obviously, I don't think anybody would be okay with being told they're cringe or whatever. It's not a nice feeling. But like, I know that these people are just internet people and it doesn't affect me. And it's like, whether I got these comments or not, I'd still be doing the same thing I did anyway. Like, because of my own personal experiences, I just, generally speaking, I don't care what people think. Obviously, if like, it depends on the situation. Like, I care what my parents think and I care what like my family and friends think, because like, if I'm being a dick around them, you know, they should tell me so I can improve. But I mean, like, I don't care what random people who mean nothing to me think. It's like a random internet person with user, you know, 7534456 as their name means nothing to me. Screaming Power asks, what do you have planned for the future? Are you going to become a full-time content creator? No, probably not. I don't like the idea of doing anything full-time. I'm too much of a, for lack of better words, a wanderer to do that. I like the freedom of being able to sort of, you know, do a bit of this, do a bit of that, do this and that. You know, I like being able to do I like to be a part-time lecturer and a part-time YouTuber and a part-time Twitch streamer and a part-time this and a part-time that, and I do commissions, and, you know, if I want to get another job, I can, because I've got the freedom on my schedule. You know, it's like, I like being able to just sort of have the freedom to do whatever I want and, like, have, like, a very free schedule, and I have the means to do that, so I'm going to do that. I guess I already am a full-time content creator, but, like, I don't want to be, like, a full-time streamer or anything like that. Because I enjoy streaming once or twice a week, but I do not have, like, I get tired by streaming very easily, and I enjoy doing other things too much to do that full time. So the answer is probably no. But, like, if that ends up happening naturally over time, I'm not gonna fight it. Vengeance asks, what keeps you determined to keep progressing on your adventure, aka animating anything else on this channel? I just enjoy making it. I don't need to be determined in the sense of, I have my support, I've got my friends, I've got my personal things, and I'm content, and I'm just happy to be doing the things. And also with drawing, the more I draw, the happier I get. I love drawing a lot, you know, even if it's time consuming, even if the topic I'm drawing isn't something I really am interested in, I still love the motion of drawing, if that makes sense. I like the feeling of putting my ideas out on paper or a tablet or whatever. I find that it's really therapeutic for me, and it just makes me happy, because it's like it's a nice way to express myself, and it just I don't know, it's I like it. So it's just because I love it, really. Don't Need to Know asks, how did your family friends react when they found out about your channel? Majority of people in my life know about my channel. My friends here, my parents know, my parents watch. My parents are watching us chat. My parents are watching us. My comment section. My parents are watching us. They know everything we do, even if they're never there. Even if they never comment, they always know. Now, my parents are very supportive and very aware. My dad's funny, because he's like, oh, this video did really well, and he's into, like, all, like, business analytics side of it. And my mom's just like, oh, the community's so sweet, yeah, they get so excited of your videos, like, and it's just like, it's two very different reactions. It's very sweet. Some of my cousins watch my videos. I'm told at least that they watch my videos. A few of them have, like, been like, oh, this video's really cool, I really like what you're doing. And I'm like, thank you. I think it's a bit weird for everybody, including myself, because outside of, like, one great aunt, I'm the only, as far as I'm aware, I'm one of the only people in my family who's doing art as, like, my profession. Everybody else in my family is, like, a lawyer, type of businessman, that sort of thing, like, you know, communication, stuff like that. I'm the only one in my family, I think at least, that's doing art. So for all of us, it's a bit like a, what is this strange industry? And I'm like, I don't know either. I don't know. I think we're all sort of, like, fascinated by the industry together and by, like, YouTube. For my parents, it's really weird, because for them, YouTube and Twitch and all that didn't exist. So I'm like, oh yeah, I did Twitch streaming and I got money from that. They're like, how? And I'm like, people's kindness, I don't know. So it's like, we're all learning together, none of us know what's happening, least of all me. Master Cooper asks, how did you get the name Grimmy Jaggers? Character from Bleach, Grimjo Jaggerjax, is my first favorite character I've ever had in my life, where I'm like, that one I like specifically more than the others. I don't know why. And also at the time, the song Moves Like Jagger was really popular and I really liked it. And I was like, Grimjo Jaggerjax, Jagger, put it together, you get Grimmy Jaggers somehow. I don't know. Also, because Grimjo, like, a nickname the fandom had for him a lot was Grimmy, because I thought it was funny to call a villain Grimmy. And I just thought that was cute. So yeah, that's where it comes from. Angel of Axes asks, how much do you like Grimjo, and are you hyped for Bleach this year? I love Grimjo. I actually started watching, like, more Bleach clips to do with him, and it's just like, it just reminded me how much I love his character and how much I love Bleach. Oh, it's so fun, it's so good, and I'm so hyped. I am so hyped for, like, the new Bleach season coming out. I read the original manga, and I think everybody had issues with it. I understood why it turned out the way it did. Yeah, it started off really good. Like, I really enjoyed it. I really enjoyed, like, the progression and everything. But the ending was, oh, I felt so bad for Tsukiko. Kubo and everything that happened. But the fact that they're doing anime of it means that they probably can make, like, can fix aspects of it. And I am so hyped. I, like, that's like the, I haven't been this excited for a show to come out, like, for an anime to come out in actual years. Like, I am so hyped for this. Captain Aqua asks, Mother, do you mind if I steal your motivation? I very do much mind. I need it. Emily King asks, what do you like to do when you're not drawing, and what games do you like? I like to listen to music a lot. It helps me process a lot of things. It helps me, you know that thing you do when you're listening to music and you sort of think up scenarios? I do that and then I act them out in my room. My parents always ask me, why do you shut yourself in your room? I was like, oh, I'm dancing to music. I was like, oh, well, you could dance with the music, you know, not in your headphones. I'm like, no, I'm basically just acting out the scene myself. It's a process thing. I'm processing things. And I do that a lot. It helps me, like, come up with story ideas, animatic ideas. It helps me process my emotions because I'm still an angsty child, even though I'm 23. I like comic books. I like to read comics. I haven't read them in a while because they're just piling up on my table at the moment. I like to draw when I'm not drawing. I like to cook. I'm not very good at it. Well, as I've heard up at it, it's not that I'm bad at it. It's just I don't put much effort in it, but I do like to cook things for myself. I like to go out to coffee shops. I like going out for walks and ended up in coffee shops a lot. I don't know why. I just like the atmosphere of coffee shops. I like seeing my friends. I'm freelance, so I have a lot of free time compared to them. But like, more, not free time, but I have more flexibility than a lot of people, a lot of my friends. Like, half my friends are, you know, are family, so they have, like, their own kids to look after. And the other half of my friends are doing masters and stuff like that, or far away. So it's like, you know, whenever I get to see them, I'm very happy. But what games are I like? Minecraft? I don't know. Minecraft, I like Outlast. I haven't played it, but yeah, I haven't finished it yet, but I remember liking it back in the day. I like the aesthetic of it. I don't play that many games, I'll be completely honest. I don't know, I like a lot of things. I prefer watching people play it, honestly. Protistium asks, have you ever considered doing a 15-minute blooper/cute Sam moments video? Also, do you like doing the awesome dad concept? I like it, but do you like it? If I didn't like it, I wouldn't do it. So if you're ever worried about me doing something I don't like, that's not a thing. I will only make something if I enjoy making it, because I have that freedom with YouTube. Have I ever considered making a 15-minute blooper cute Sam at the moment? Yes, I have. I'm collecting clips. I have a date specifically I'm thinking of to post it. You'll just have to wait. Sam becomes sleep deprived is a mood. Questions, will there be more awesome dad? Yes, there will be. I have two specific animatic ideas specifically. One is to do like Tommy being babysitted by different people of the SMP, and the other one is the prison lore of this alternate universe sort of summarized, basically using a song but as a meme, but like it's such a banger, so I don't care. Equinox Dragon asks, do you have any words of advice for people who want to start or try animating? Yeah, don't be hard on yourself, just have fun. It's the same thing with drawing tips, just have fun. Also, if you're like, you want to like do like a long animatic, plan it out. So like, have like little like mini milestones for yourself, like plan things out, have a script, have an idea, have different like just like a guide for yourself, because I think the worst thing to do when you, personally for me at least, as the type of person I am, is to just wing it. I think it's definitely best to script it, like have an idea of what you want to do, basically. So then you have like, you're not just like left to the wind and, you know, being, you know, drowned by the current of work. You're like, okay, I need to do this, this and that, and I know what I need to do, and we're good to go. If you could have any superpower, only one, what would it be and why? Timothy Brigalia also asked, if you could have one power, would it be? Probably teleportation. I like traveling, but with some types of travel, like plane travel and stuff like that, it's just, I've done it so much over my life, but I'd like to just skip that. It'd be so much more practical and would like save so much money if I could just like teleport. And it'd also be like making things like seeing my parents and stuff like that much easier, because my parents live in different countries. So it would just be so much more convenient, like a portal teleportation type of thing. Third, do you have any pets? If not, or even if you already do, what is your dream pet? What is my dream pet? I don't really have a dream pet. I like the idea of having a British bulldog. I don't know why. They're so scrunkly, and I want one, and they're chunky, and I like them. I also love to have I just like cats in general. I don't know why, but I really want a tarantula. I probably wouldn't own one because it's a lot to take care of it, but I just like the, I just think they look cool. Tarantulas are so cool. Fourth, if you could bring any mythical creature to reality, what would it be? I'm going to be really basic. I'd say Pegasus, because that's what five-year-old me would say. Five-year-old me adored Pegasi so much. Like, not because of, like, My Little Pony or anything like that. I just love the idea of a horse that can fly. And so probably that, because I just think it's so cool. Honey Drop the Unicorn asks, what D&D classes would you give each one of the Dreamers SFP members, and can you do a height chart? No. No, I don't have the time. I'm not invested enough in the D&D to really know what any of the classes mean. And I just think that all the characters are their own thing. I don't think you can really label any of them. They're just too many of the characters are too nuanced to be considered a single class. No is the answer, sorry. Eleanor Powell asks, I always wanted to know, is the J in your name pronounced like a J or like a Y? A Y, rather. It's pronounced J, it's Grimmy Jaggers. But if you call me Grim Jaggers or Grim or whatever, that's fine. Probably not Jaggers, because that's my mascot, so it might get confusing. But if you call me Grimmy Jaggers, that's fine. Most people seem find it easier to say Grim Jaggers rather than Grimmy Jaggers, which I'm fine with. I don't mind. Kiki Off, hello Kiki. Kiki Off asks, how many fandoms was I in and how big of an impact you made in them? Again, I never really interacted with the fandom. I mainly just stuck to my side of the internet. But I guess Hitalia is one of the main ones I was in. I guess Voltron a little bit as well, Legendary Defender. I'm always in a Trainwreck fandom for some reason. For the most part, I never really joined any fandoms. I mainly just made OCs and just stuck to my side of the internet with myself inserts. How much of a big impact I made on them? None, I would say, but there were a couple fanfictions that got a lot of hits. They were bad. They got a lot of views. I got a lot of comments from these fanfics, but like, I disowned them. They're dead to me. And they're just not good. They're badly written. The concepts are bad. Half the concepts are stolen from other fanfictions I used to read at the time. I don't read fanfictions anymore. I've traumatized myself. So I never made it a big impact. I never did. I just had a couple fanfics that did well, and that's about it. So the answer is not many fandoms and very little impact, if any. Rocket Out Lou asks, do I play any instruments? If not, would you want to learn one? Which one? Yes, I do play an instrument. I play the flute. I'm not very good at it, but I have fun and I like it a lot. So if I was to learn a new one, I don't know, drums seem fun. Drums would be kind of cool. Guitar would be good as well. I like to play the guitar. My mom plays the guitar. What's my favorite ship? I don't really, if you're talking Dream SMP ships, I don't ship any of the Dream SMP characters. It just, I don't know. I don't like it. And my favorite Dream SMP group, well, Tommy and Osamdu as a duo. I don't know what their name is. Volta duo, which is Osamdu and Dream, are my favorite for sure. My favorite trio though is probably Punk Foolish and Sam though, because they're really funny. Sam and Foolish also a good duo. They work well together. Halkia asks, very important. Okay, do you like Pokemon? First of all, why is Pokemon in quotation marks? I don't like the implications of that. I don't know what that means. Do I like Pokemon? I've never played it. I don't dislike it. I don't really have much interaction with it. I don't have an opinion on it. I never really did video games that much as a kid, honestly. I don't dislike it. No. Georgia Bunting asks, favorite Pokemon? Skitty. I watched one episode of the Pokemon anime, cartoon, whatever, and Skitty was fighting some big monster and was getting beaten up. And I was like, no, not the little pink cat flower thing. It's cute. And as the fact that Skitty kept, you know, standing up, I think. I can't remember if that's what happened. But in my mind, I remember as Skitty getting beaten up, but always standing back up. And I really liked that. And I thought it was cute. So Skitty's my favorite, just because it's the only one I know beside Pikachu. Soulkeeper asks, what was your favorite game when you were a child? I don't play enough games to really know. I don't know. Wii Fit. I don't know. I used to play this, like, so Totally Spies used to have an online platform you could play. They can't play it anymore. But I used to play, they used to have like an official website, and you could like play as like a spy. You could like make a character and play as a spy, I think. And I really enjoyed that. I spent a lot of time playing that. So probably Totally Spies online game, I guess. I'm not sure. Spring asks, what is your favorite color? And what is your least favorite color? My favorite color is turquoise. Don't know why. I don't really have a least favorite color. to be fair. I just like colours in general. Shadow asks, favourite game, series, literature, series, etc. that you would recommend to the people watching? I'm going to view your children, so... To the adults in the audience. If you like that sort of stuff, The Boys comics, not the TV show, actually F the TV show. The Boys comics, I would suggest, if you like that sort of like... extreme gore, extreme content stuff. I think it's very fun. I like the story. I like the characters. I would recommend that. If not, I'm gonna be basic and suggest the Chronicles of Narnia because I think they're cool. Daredevil, but that's a popular series. I don't really watch enough series and stuff to really give recommendations. Dead Eyes by John McCrea. Well, he's the artist, John McCrea. Dead Eyes is a really good comic. I would suggest it. Again, it's more adult orientated, but like, it's fun. Also, Techno Freak, because I'm doing stories for Techno Freak. Well, one story for Techno Freak, and John Charles is very cool. So Techno Freak, it's a UK comic. You should check it out. Ghost Slits asks, other than Dream SMP, what other show series are you into? Honestly, none. I guess, I don't know, does Markiplier's Scary Game series count? I guess that. I'm really picky with the things I enjoy. I'm really, really picky with the things I enjoy. So it's like, it takes a lot to get me into something. There's like old shows, well, old shows, I mean, there's like shows I finished that I really like for example, Bleach, Naruto, Daredevil, stuff like that. So I guess in that sense, I'm into those shows, but like any like, ongoing shows in the moment. I just don't watch any because I'm not invested, but I don't know. My friends will tell you they have to make me sit down with them for me to watch anything. I did not watch the original Star Wars trilogy until my first year of university about 4 years ago, three, 4 years ago. Like, my friend had to make me watch it because I wasn't gonna watch it otherwise. But I don't really enjoy sitting down and watching shows that much. I don't know, I'm just picky. What do I think Rambu, Vixars, and Lasers Limbos are? I don't know, honestly. I'm not much into theories. Like, I don't know, I like basing things off of canon, like things that are for sure happened, or like things that have already happened. I don't really care to think about what could be, the future, whatever. I'm not into like theories, so I don't really think anything. I don't know enough about Vixstar and Lazar to really have an opinion anyway. Blueblade asks, what is my favorite movie? I like the Hangover trilogy a lot. I haven't seen it in a while, so I probably might not like it anymore, but I remember really enjoying it because I thought it was funny. Maybe my opinion has changed since, I don't know. But I liked it back in the day. I like Balto a lot. That was one of my favorite movies as a kid. The Great Mouse Detective I like a lot. I still like it a lot to this day. I don't know, I think it's quirky. I like it. I like Rattigan. I like the Red Dragon, like the Hannibal from the Hannibal Lecter trilogy. I like the Red Dragon a lot. I watched it recently with my friend, and that was really good. I like the Robert Downey Jr. Sherlock Holmes. I don't know if they're my favorite, but I really enjoyed them. Keaton JB asks, who's your favorite child on a Discord? I guess we're gonna have to go with Emily King asks, tea or coffee? And opinions on snakes. Tea or coffee? Both. I'm currently drinking coffee, but I like both. And opinions on snakes. Snakes are very poggers. Little danger noodles. They're venomous. Away from me is nice, but I think they're cool. If they're not venomous and they're not gonna, you know, kill me, I would love to hold it. Emma Glade asks, if there was anyone in the world you could spend a day with, who would it be? If I could choose a dead person to spend a day with, in a sense of like, I could meet them when they're alive, not when they're dead, it'd be C.S. Lewis. I don't know, he seems like he'd be really fun to talk to. I'd love to, like, to, I don't know, I just, I'd like to have a chat with him. Or like, one of my ancestors would be cool. Because I have some questions sometimes about stuff. My ancestors did, and I'd like to know. And for somebody who'd be alive, the obvious answer obviously would be like the content creators I make art for, so like, you know, Awesome Dude, Tommy, obviously those peeps, obviously. Awesome Dude is on the top of the list, obviously. I guess Hugh Jackman. I really like Hugh Jackman. He's probably my favorite actor. Pigeons Are Cool asks, thoughts on pigeons, poggers. Plague, hello Plague, asks, would you rather have unlimited bacon but no games, or games, unlimited games and no games? I'm pretty sure there's meant to be a no bacon there somewhere. The answer is yes. Alihoof asks, hi Alihoof, why are you so cool? I'm not, but thank you, I appreciate it. You're cooler, Alihoof is cooler. Nia, hello Nia, will you marry me? I think you might have to fight Charlie for that, but if whichever one wins the fight, yes. Jordan. Hello, Jordan. These are all my IRL friends. How does it feel to actually reach 70k? I feel no different. you know when there's like, you know, you turn from 17 to 18, like 19, like 20 to 21. It's like I have gained a number. Hey. nothing's changed. It's just the number's bigger and my anxiety rises. Woo. Giselle Dragon asks, what's your name? My name is publicly available. If you want to search for it, if you want to be little detectives, you may. Whoever finds my name gets a cookie. I'll give you a hint though. There was actually a Dream SMP obscure character that has my name. I talk about it on Twitter. Go find it. But if you do find my name, I'd rather you call me by my username. Having people call me by my real name online's weird. So just my username is fine, thank you. Faves Eden asks, well, who's your favorite OC? Share some fun facts about them. My favorite OC is probably Weirdo. His name's Weirdo, yes, I know. He is a man, I know. You wouldn't think it because of the eyelashes. He is Irish. He can eat anything. When I mean anything, I mean that's his power. He could digest everything and anything, which means that he is very acidic as a creature. He's got like 4 adopted children. He has 2 dogs and has a pygmy goat. Also, he murders people. Oral Fail is coming in with like 26 questions, so we're gonna speed through. How did you learn to draw? I self-taught everything. I just used tutorials online. I just drew because it was fun. Observations, life, like drawing like actual people in front of me, stuff like that. And also then I did 3 years of university where I specifically studied, you know, how to make comics and stuff like that. So generally self-taught, and then got the boosts I needed and like the proper guides and everything I needed to continue. Why did I start making videos? I don't know. It just felt like something fun to do. I just thought it was fun. How did you find ideas for videos? When I would draw things, I just recorded and then I'd upload it because I used to do speed paints. So it would just be that. With nowadays, it's mainly inspired by live streams, Dream SMP content, Awesome Dude, Tommy, songs, stuff like that. What do you draw of the body first? I draw the sketches. Usually I start with the head and then I go from there. You know, a little circle, little cross, then do the little guidelines, and then I start from there. Do you find making these videos fun? Yes. Do you and your family know about your channel? Yes. If they do they like and support what you do? Yes. Who is your favorite Dream SMP member? Awesome Dude. Are you fluent in English? Yes. Why do you make these videos about the Dream SMP? Because they're fun, they make me happy, they're challenging, and I really appreciate the work that the content creators go into it, and I would like to show my appreciation by drawing it. Whose lore do you think is the most interesting? Awesome Dudes. Do you have a crush on any of the Dream SMP members? Skip if you want. Which ships is your favorite ships? I do not have any. Which ship do you just absolutely despise? Honestly, all of them. No. All the ones that the fandom sort of doesn't stop talking about. Specifically DNF. I'm so sick and tired of hearing about it. What is your OC? I have over 100. Do you have to be more specific? OC backstory, explanation, information, too many. If you mean specifically Daggers though, he exists. He exists. He's basically my conscience telling me to stop messing about. There is no backstory, there is no explanation, there is no information. He just exists. Why did you make your OC like that? I like it. I saw a design that was kind of similar, like with the hair and the mask, and I thought that looked cool. I think it was a human version of a Happy Tree Friends character. I think it was a human version of specifically Nutty. I'm pretty sure that's what it was, like a fan-made version. And I think I took the hair from like this human version and I took the face marks from like Lifty and Shifty. I think that's what it was. Yeah, I think Happy Tree Friends made Jaggers for me. And then I gave him a suit because I like it. Do you have any plans of making any new OCs? I have so many OCs. You have no idea. I've got so many. Are you a girl or boy? Girl. How do you keep yourself motivated to make these videos? Spite. Who's your favorite YouTuber? Markiplier. Do you plan on making an animated movie? No. Never. 26. Is this too many questions for you? No, it's fine. I'm happy having questions. Melahai, who is a channel member, give me money, asks, will you ever call it a day from YouTube one day? Maybe. Not anytime soon though. I don't have any plans to end anytime soon. It's just if it happens, it happens, and I'll tell you guys and I'll make sure you guys are aware that it happens. Before the time being, nope. I'm gonna keep doing it because why not? It's fun. Jasmine asks, how many hours do I take to make animatics or animations? So many hours. So many hours. 3-4 days worth of hours. So many hours. Red Panda 2 asks, what inspired you to do the things you do? Yes, all of it. music. Well, my parents have always been very encouraging, so yeah. Just everything, a lot of things, life, family, friends, connections. Obviously, Awesome Dude and Co., Dream SMP. I have anything and everything, really. What's my favorite book? The Chronicles of Narnia. I don't know, I just makes it, that makes me happy. I like it a lot. Cyril Cruz asks, how did you think to make your Sam OCF? I'm pretty sure you mean my Sam design. I mean, it had a really interesting design, like the shades that always look like his actual eyes. The wide mouth with smoke coming out of it, the fact that his roar is a tiger roar, and his emo hairstyle. It's really bizarre and different from anyone's Sam designs. Also, I really want to see your Sam coloured without his shades and masks going for creeper monster mode. Me too! I also want to see that, I just don't have the opportunity to. Oh, Sam dude, sir, if you're watching this, give me the opportunity. Otherwise I will make the opportunity happen. No, I'm joking, I'm joking. I just thought it looked cool. I don't know. I was just like, I want to give him a reason to wear the mask. And so obviously, like, the whole, he's a creeper, he wears a mask to sort of, you know, regulate his breathing and everything. And so he doesn't go kaboom. I was like, that makes sense. That's logical. But like, also, I was like, but I want to add something more. I really like the way snakes just go rah, when they need to yawn. And or, not yawn, but they need to like, they're basically resetting their jaw, basically. I was like, I like that, that's cool. And also I remembered Annie from Attack on Titan. I was like, that is also cool. Awesome dude, there you go. You now have that jaw for some reason. Tiger roar, it's not actually a tiger roar. It's just, it's a weird combinations of like different monster roars. It's like a hissing roar. I'm not sure what it is, but it's like, I think I took it. I can't remember where I took it from. I have the video somewhere, but it's like a hissing monster roar type of thing. This emo hairstyle. His eyes just swept to the side. It's not emo. What do you mean? Yeah, I don't know. I was like, I like this. There we go. I am updating his design though after he gets his scar across his face. I'm very hyped to draw it. The Ray asks, do you have any big projects for the future? If so, what are they? And how long do you plan on doing YouTube and Twitch and content in general? I'm planning on doing it as long as I can, basically. I don't have any plans of any sort. I'm sure you've noticed, I don't really have much plans in my life other than planning out my videos. I honestly, until I get bored, until I run out of content, until something else comes up. I didn't plan on this becoming an income for me. I'm certainly not going to be the one to plan to stop the income. So I guess whenever it's just over, I guess. Any big projects for the future? No, not other than like videos. Obviously, I mean, I guess the only big project is getting to 100k and making and doing I'm doing a 24-hour charity live stream while wearing a cat maid outfit because I promised that because I'm an idiot. so other than that, not really. That's up to you guys to get me to 100k if you want to see me in a maid outfit wearing cat ears, I guess. But other than that, not really, no. And that's all the questions. Yeah, thank you for the Q&A. I'm gonna have so much editing to do. that was 84, well, more than 84, it was 84 screenshots, so many, many questions. Hopefully you enjoyed it. It's very long, I'm sorry. Good luck going through all of that. Animatic out soon, guys. Bye, everybody. Take care. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.